Hello, welcome again. Today we have another probability problem. Here it goes. The probability that it will rain today is 0.65. The probability that it will rain tomorrow is 0.4. Now, the question states, find the probability that A, it will rain on both days. Now this means it can rain tomorrow, but it hasn't rained today. Question 2. Part B. It will not rain tomorrow. Now, the focus is on not rain tomorrow. Therefore, if it rains today, it's okay, but there should be no rain tomorrow. Part C. It will rain on at least one day. What does this mean? If it rains in both of the days, it's fine. But at least one of the 2 days, there should be rain. Now, the easiest approach to this problem is by using what we call a tree diagram. We are told that it will rain today and it will rain tomorrow. Now, we can have today and we can have tomorrow. We can use R to represent rain, and we can use NR to represent no rain. Now, if it can rain today, that means there is also another possibility of no rain. Given that the probability for rain today is 0.65. Now, the corresponding probability will be 1 minus 0.65, giving us 0.35. Hence, the probability for no rain will be 0.35. Having rain today, it's possible that it can rain again, or it might not rain tomorrow. Now, we are told in the question that the probability for rain tomorrow is 0.4. That means even if there was no rain the previous day, but having rain today, it is 0.4. Now, it rains today and rain tomorrow is given as 0.4, meaning the corresponding for no rain tomorrow will be 0.6. So we can allocate 0.6. Therefore, our possible outcomes are having rain today and having rain tomorrow, or having rain today and no rain tomorrow, or no rain today and also having rain tomorrow, and finally no rain today and also no rain tomorrow. Now, these are possible outcomes. Good. Now we can go straight to our question. It will rain on both days, meaning rain today and rain tomorrow. So, rain today and rain tomorrow. The probability for rain today is given as 0.65, and the probability for rain tomorrow is given as 0.4. The product of the two will give us the outcome of 0.26. Let's go to the next question. It will rain. It will not rain tomorrow. Now, having rained tomorrow doesn't matter having rained today. In the same case, if we have no rain tomorrow, we might not have no rain today, doesn't matter. Therefore, our two possible outcomes could be, we might have rain today, and rain tomorrow. Or, we might have no rain today, and again no rain tomorrow. Because our main focus is having no rain tomorrow. Therefore, we can have rain and no rain, or we can have no rain today and again no rain tomorrow. Now, let's go back to our probabilities. Having rain today is 0.65 and having no rain tomorrow is 0.6. Or we can have another option where having no rain today 0.35 and having no rain tomorrow, that is 0.6. Now the product of rain and no rain will be 0.35 and we don't have rain tomorrow is given by 0.65 times 0.6, that is 0.39. That is rain and no rain, 0.39 plus having no rain today and having no rain tomorrow, giving us 0.21, summing up to 0.6. Now let's look at our last part. It will rain on at least one day. So, it's possible that it can rain today and rain tomorrow. Doesn't matter because we want at least one day to rain. So if it's more, then it's fine. But it might rain today and no rain tomorrow. It's also fine. Why? Because we shall have one day with rain. But also, we might have no rain today, but we have rain tomorrow. It's also fine because at least on one of the days we shall have rain. So our possible outcomes here would be having rain and rain the following days, or having rain today and no rain tomorrow, or having no rain today and having rain tomorrow. Now, what would be the probabilities for this? Rain today, rain tomorrow, giving us 0.65 times 0.4, or rain today and no rain tomorrow, or no rain and rain. Now, what would be the product for this? Rain and rain gives us 0.26 plus having rain today and no rain tomorrow will give us 0.39, and no rain today, rain tomorrow, this will give us 0.14, summing up to 0.79. There we go. in such a problem, it's relevant to use a tree diagram because in a tree diagram, it gives you outcomes in a very easy approach. Thank you for watching. If you like the explanation, you can subscribe to my channel. My name is Ishengoma Kiyomire. Thank you. See you next time.